Hello and welcome to the Monsoon Outlook briefing provided by the National Weather Service in Las Vegas. This briefing will spend the next few minutes discussing what the monsoon is and how it affects our weather both here and in the greater southwestern United States. We will then transition into how we go about making monsoon season predictions and what we can expect this year. Keep in mind our outlooks are subject to change and are simply designed to help you plan ahead and prepare for the upcoming season. So what is the monsoon? Well, contrary to popular usage, a monsoon is not a heavy thunderstorm or torrential downpour. Actually, a monsoon is a seasonal reversal of the prevailing winds, which leads to changes in the precipitation patterns. Westerly winds, which prevail during the spring, begin to weaken and lift north of the jet stream by early summer. This allows the winds to become southerly or southeasterly across the region, causing moisture to flow northward into the southwest. Here in the Mojave Desert and the southern Great Basin, our first surges of moisture usually arrive around July, with periodic surges of moisture persisting through the summer months and gradually tapering off around September. A significant fraction of our annual rainfall comes to the region during this time of year, especially in northwest Arizona, where some locations receive a third or more of their annual rainfall during the summer months. Typically, the greatest moisture is directed into Arizona, with eastern California and southern Nevada on the western fringe of the monsoon circulation. While rainfall is always a welcome relief during the dry spring months, storms commonly bring with them the threat of heavy rain and flash flooding, as well as dangerous lightning and other possible hazards. How can we predict the monsoon, you ask? Well, firstly, it's important to state that the southwestern monsoon is not easily predicted, and there's limited skill in anticipating if the monsoon will be wet or dry. Additionally, due to the small-scale nature of showers and thunderstorms, rainfall can vary dramatically over the course of the summer from one point to another. So while one location may finish above normal, it may not be representative of the whole region. With that said, one indicator we often look at is the Southern Oscillation, better known as El Niño and La Niña. While the state of the Southern Oscillation has implications on our winter weather, its summer influence is much less pronounced and poorly understood. We are currently anticipating a developing El Niño over the course of the summer. This has historically resulted in somewhat less active monsoon seasons, although tropical systems in the eastern Pacific Ocean sometimes are more frequent in El Niño years, which can induce brief surges of moisture into the Mojave Desert. It has been such a dry winter and spring, could that mean a wet summer? Well, unfortunately, there is little statistical support that dry winters or springs will lead to a wet summer. It really can go either way. Perhaps the most critical factor in influencing the southwestern monsoon is determining where the monsoon high will set up this summer. Being on the western fringe of the monsoon circulation, our region needs occasional westerly pushes from Arizona to really benefit from the monsoon. If the monsoon high sets up too far east, it may lead to a drier season overall with more frequent breaks. A more westerly setup would favor bursts of activity across the Mojave Desert and southern Great Basin. Finally, we consider the output of various climate models which anticipate the upcoming season's weather based on a variety of factors such as observed trends, soil moisture, pressure patterns, and sea surface temperatures. The official outlook from the Climate Prediction Center calls for an elevated chance of above-normal precipitation across most of the Mojave Desert and southern Great Basin. This is based on strong and consistent signals from climate and statistical models for enhanced precipitation across the Intermountain West. The influence of a summer El Niño adds a greater degree of uncertainty to the forecast, especially since historically El Niño rainfall patterns are a little bit drier. Keep in mind, monsoon rainfall can vary dramatically from one point to another, and your home's location may not necessarily reflect what fell in another part of town. Monsoon precipitation can vary greatly on a small scale due to the nature of thunderstorm activity, which further highlights how difficult it can be to predict. So here's what we can expect, regardless of exactly how the monsoon behaves. We can expect to see an uptick in cloud cover and precipitation beginning in July, and peaking in August before gradually tapering off in September. Precipitation coverage will be greatest and most common in northwest Arizona, where some higher elevation locations commonly receive rainfall during the more active points of the season, while lower elevation locations will receive rainfall but less frequently. The last graphic shown here illustrates lightning strike density across the region, with much higher storm frequency depicted across northwest Arizona, while gradually diminishing with westward extent. This further highlights how the Mojave Desert and southern Great Basin often finds itself right on the edge of the best monsoon moisture. What hazards does monsoon season bring? Perhaps the biggest hazard we face in monsoon season is the threat of flash flooding. Las Vegas and the greater Mojave Desert region have a long history of flash flooding, so it's important to be mindful of this type of weather during monsoon season and be prepared to seek higher ground if flash flooding strikes. Remember to never drive your vehicle through flooded roadways, as the force of the water may be much greater than it appears, so turn around, don't drown. Also of concern are locations near recent burn areas, as the burned forest and hillsides cannot absorb the heavy rainfall as they could in the past, leading to rapid flash flooding, rock falls, mud, and debris flows. Strong storms can also bring with them the threat of gusty winds and microbursts, which can be damaging at times and strike very suddenly. They can also pick up large quantities of dust, leading to rapidly reduced visibility in dust storms. Lightning is also a significant hazard with our monsoon season storms, so be safety conscious and go inside when thunder roars. And finally, expect bursts and breaks throughout the season as our changing weather patterns dictate where the greatest moisture goes. When the Four Corners High is favorably situated in the southwest, active weather and thunderstorm chances will dominate the forecast, while surges of dry, stable air from the west will disrupt that pattern, leading to periods of dryness. These breaks can often result in very hot periods of weather in the desert southwest, and while monsoon storms can be dangerous, heat is still the nation's number one weather-related killer. Thanks for watching, and be sure to follow us on our various social media outlets, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube, where we will be sharing additional information for Monsoon Safety Awareness Week about local hazards and how to prepare for them and stay safe as we head into the summer season.